I think about what I need to do. time music for Revelation song.
What time is it?
5 minutes?
No, it's 26. That's fine.
You said 24.
It's okay.
When you're done, we need to reset this area for the singers. And one stand can stay for Lydia and me.
Good afternoon. We are going to get going with some concert music, some ensemble music. This is our clarinet ensemble. This is one of the pieces that they performed for solo and ensemble contest. The next group that I'll play is a trumpet duet that also played for solo ensemble contest.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. It is great to have you here. My name is David Mertz. I serve as president of Great Plains Lutheran High School. And on behalf of all of us here at GPL, we welcome you here this afternoon and welcome those who are watching online. Thank you for being a part of this afternoon. Something I've been reflecting on lately is just God's amazing grace. God's amazing grace in general, and now in particular in relation to Great Plains Lutheran High School, God's amazing grace for 25 years. This is the 25th school year
of Great Plains Lutheran High School. I think it gives us a chance to pause, it gives us a chance to reflect, just to say thank you, Lord. And then I think about this school year and the fact that we've been able to continue this Christ-centered education throughout the school year with all these different activities going on, ways in which we get to use the gifts that God has given to us and praise and glorify Him in the things that we do. I see other things that I'm reflecting on in just the last couple of days, whether that's having a bunch of grade schoolers here a weekend ago and getting to interact with them and their families and talk about the blessings of Christian education, or a board of directors meeting yesterday where several hours were spent thinking about the ministry of this school and looking forward in the years and the plans to come. And I think of an organization like Good Stewards Incorporated Thrift Store that just had its annual meeting, its 25th annual meeting, where God has blessed this school with over $1,400,000 in support just through the stuff that God gives to us, and then we have the opportunity to pass on to others so that they can be a blessing to them in their lives and in our community. So many blessings that you see around you, including the students that were behind me, that are now in front of me, and the gifts that they get to use and the gifts that they do use. We had students volunteering the other day to make thank you phone calls to people like you, just to say thank you for your support. God's grace is evident. God's grace is evident as we have another opportunity today to simply be here, to simply hear more of God's grace shared with us through word and song. May God bless you as you listen. May God bless you as you hear. May God bless us as we celebrate and rejoice in His grace.
make my works in vain. But then the Holy Spirit revives my soul again.
If you take a look at the page that Rejoice in God is on, whichever page that is, we would invite you to join with us in singing stanzas 2, 4, and 5.
Father, Son, for us, how bad.
B-flat concert, please.
B-flat concert.
Good afternoon, and thank you all for being here this afternoon. It is great that we get to be here and we get to do this, and it certainly is a privilege to rehearse with them every day, as we are able every day or every other day, whichever the ensemble meets. And I thank the Lord for every opportunity. Thank you, students, for all of your work through this time, and a lot of work in a short amount of time. It's really appreciated. There are a number of thank yous in the program. Thank you to Mr. Rosenthal and Mr. Klenke for helping get sound and everything set up, and Deanna for accompanying, and Mrs. Rosenthal for getting a lot of the solo and ensemble stuff organized, as well as playing for that earlier. And a special thank you to Lydia for designing the program cover. Lydia is the senior. She's in the band and the choir. And so thank you to her for that extra time and effort. We really appreciate that. There are many other thank yous. Individuals that worked on solos and special music, thank you. Thank you for tuning in online. It's really been a great spring and a great opportunity to put this concert together for you, to praise God all to his glory. We will conclude in your program. This piece was written by a former music teacher. At the time, she was Tracy Lemke, now Tracy Fedke, for the 25th anniversary of GPL. And Olivia will sing verse 1 to introduce it to you.
Good afternoon again. On behalf of the staff and students of Great Plains Lutheran High School, I'd again like to thank you for attending our spring concert this afternoon, whether in person or online. We're very much appreciative of you taking the time to be with us. Our students and our director, Mr. Martins, and everybody involved, very thankful and blessed for the opportunity to share Jesus' love with you this afternoon through their music. Mr. Martins highlighted the thank yous on the back page of the program. In addition to those, of course, we want to thank Mr. Martins as well for all of the time and effort and energy he spends in planning all of this and leading the students in rehearsal and finally leading them in their performance today. So let's thank Mr. Martins. I'm sure Mr. Martins is counting down. I'm not sure if you are as well, but if my math is correct and if everything goes according to plan, there may just be one more concert in this gym before we get to move into the new Performing Arts Center. Speaking of which, if you want to take a little bit of time afterward, if you go down the hallway, I think room 125 is open on the left, and if you go in there and peek out through the windows, you can kind of see into the Performing Arts Center. There's still a lot of mud and dirt in there, but you can kind of see how things are starting to take shape on the left side where the auditorium will be, and then way over on the right side where the music rehearsal space will be. But I'd encourage you to take a peek in there and see how the progress is coming along. After a little bit of time to mingle, we'll be transitioning to our winter awards ceremony. So we'll orient our speakers up in front here. We'll use the chairs on the floor and any additional seating that's needed in the bleachers, but we'll get that going before too long. So please plan to transition into that if you plan to stick around for that. Additionally, I'd just like to wish all of you God's continued blessings through the season of Lent. I think just 2 weeks away from Holy Week and an opportunity again to walk to Calvary with our Savior and see God's love demonstrated on the cross for us, and then get to again celebrate the victory that we have in Jesus' resurrection on Easter. If you're traveling home this evening any distance, wish you God's blessings and safe travels as well. Again, thank you for being here this afternoon. God's richest blessings to you.
I think we'll give the 2-minute warning and then we'll get started for our winter activities. Mr. Klanke, could you give us a little more volume on number one, please? We should do with both, probably. That's what Janine's done. Six. Ooh, that was loud. Mr. Bauer has number six, and I have number one. All right, good. All right, looks like we have everything operating again. Let's begin. A couple minutes early. I could tell the boys, let's start so we can end. It's so nice to be looking at faces and not a camera, and trying to be coherent and try to get all the things edited for our award ceremony. Hopefully, Lord willing, those days are behind us. So, as we begin our 2020-2021 awards for the winter season, first of all, I'd like to start by extending a few thank yous from the athletic director hat that I get to wear. And the most important group that I need to thank, first of all of our parents, whether you're here or whether you're tuning in online. Your child or your children that you get to send here to Great Plains are the greatest gift that God has given you. And the trust that you put in our institution here to carry out our mission, to assist you in helping these young men and women become lifelong disciples of Christ, is not something that we take lightly. Whether you live locally here or very far away or anywhere in between, that trust that you extend to us is something we take very seriously. And what a wonderful opportunity it is to see your students develop their skills in the various activities that we're going to highlight today. So first of all, parents, thank you for that respect and trust that you put in us. I also would like to thank all of those that were involved with the crazy adjustments of the winter season. You can always expect winter weather to play a role here in South Dakota, but of course, with going through the COVID season and having to have things adjusted both in December and in February, it's just been one of those crazy years. So thank you for flexibility. Please know that every decision that was made was not made easily. whether that was adjusting athletic schedules, school schedules, or whatever. And I think we all are kind of living in the age of understanding, but it should be recognized and expressed from our side, from school administration, especially in the realm of athletics and activities. I'd like to thank the faculty that worked behind the scenes, that worked the games, making sure that we had a top-notch operation again this year. Our office ladies that are extremely behind the scenes, but Mrs. Miller, Mrs. Hesford, and Janine for all the Facebook posts. Just tremendous, tremendous work. I'd like to thank all of our coaches and directors, both head and assistants, for dedicating your winter to our student athletes. The time, I know, it's a lot of time, a lot of brain cells, and probably some sleepless nights as you wonder if your people are prepared and what to do with the personnel that we've been given here. But I'm just so blessed to be able to consider myself one of the coaches, not just for the winter season, but for our entire coaching staff here at GPL. So thank you for all of the time and dedication and preparation for our students. And then I also like to thank our student athletes. To be involved in extracurricular activities and to go through the rigors of your curriculum is a big deal. And the dedication to your team, the hours spent in practices and performances and bus trips and adjusting to COVID and wearing your masks and all the stuff, it's a lot of stuff. And so I thank you for your commitment to your team and to your teammates and to your studies and everything that involves being a student athlete. I think it was even more, is it more of a challenge this year than any other, I think. So thank you to them. I'd also like to thank everybody that was part of the live streaming production. I know that for various reasons, sometimes as a school, we limited attendance, and so not everybody was able to come to the activities, or just because of distance and schedules and whatnot, we couldn't come to all the home activities. So what a tremendous blessing to be able to provide a live streaming service that is much better than others. Many, many public schools dove into the realm of live streaming. We've been doing it for years, and our production was really well done. So thanks to all who worked the cameras and broadcasted and put the schedules together for that. Most importantly, though, I need to thank God for everything that he's provided, all the blessings. And Pastor Mertz talked about this slightly at the beginning of the concert, but it's true. I'm thankful to God for the student-athletes that we have this year. It's just been a tremendous opportunity to work with them, and although we haven't been able to fully see our goal of staying in person the entire year, we've been able to do it for the majority, and what a wonderful blessing that has been. I'm thankful for the opportunity that we had to even have a season. I'm sure most of the coaches will talk about how our season got cut short, and we didn't have the opportunity to play a full season and do all the things that we normally do, but thank God we live in a state that allowed us to have a season. There are high schoolers that still have not played a basketball game this year, basketball players. So it'll be wonderful for the opportunities that we had. I know Mr. Bauer talked about it with the girls, and I did with the boys. Every day that we get to bounce a basketball or do the things we love is a blessing. Whether it's a practice or a game, what a blessing from God. And so I think that's important to set the stage for our night tonight as well. I'm going to real briefly talk about the awards so that each coach doesn't need to, and then we'll roll into the different teams. You'll hear different awards awarded to the students this evening. You'll hear MVP, which is pretty straightforward. We'll also award a Panther Award for each of our activities, and that's a unique one to our school. And I know many of you are familiar with it, but if you are not, real quick, the Panther Award is given to a student athlete that displays tremendous character. They are the type of student athlete that the coach wants the others on the team to model. And they really have exemplified what being a student athlete at our school is all about. They don't necessarily have to be the most talented player or performer. Sometimes they are, sometimes they are not. But it's like we're putting a spotlight on if there was a student coming into our school saying, I want you to be like him or her. And that's what our Panther Award is all about. You'll also hear awards for some other types, like Most Improved or Defensive Player of the Year, things of that nature, which again are rather straightforward. Other awards will be lettering. Each event has criteria that a student athlete must meet in order to letter. Others that did not letter will receive a certificate of participation for their dedication, even though they did not meet the lettering criteria. So the order for our events for tonight, we're going to watch a slideshow here momentarily, and then girls basketball will be first, followed by one act, and then cheerleading, and then boys basketball. So Mr. Bauer has our slideshow queued up for our four events for this awards ceremony. So if we could get the lights, and Mr. Bauer. Seeing a couple of those images just reminded me, maybe you saw them when you came in, but we do have some extra posters laying out on a table. So as you leave, if you would like to take one, especially if you had a student on the varsity teams for the basketball teams, please take one. All right, we're going to go into girls basketball. And one of the most striking things when you looked at the roster was how young this team was. We had strong numbers of eighth graders help our JV numbers, and I'm sure Coach Bauer will talk about that, but I'm really excited to see this group. It's a kind of a rare thing. They're all going to be back next year because there were no seniors on this team. So to talk about the team and their season, Mr. Bauer.
Thank you.
I'm going to start by throwing our football coach under the bus. If you start to feel like this is long, I compared notes with him, and this is 500 words shorter than his was in the fall. Sorry, coach. It's a privilege and an honor for me to speak to you this afternoon on behalf of Panther Girls Basketball. I'm going to begin by introducing our student athletes and our managers by team. So girls, when you hear your name, please stand up, and then we'll applaud for you at the end. So our junior varsity team was composed of Hallie Bauer, Taylor Bendix, Brianna Cordell, Esther Cameron, Emma Dornbush, Paige Engels, Linnea Hayes, Olivia Holman, Myra Lentz, Mirta Manzango, Marcus, Katie Newman, Grace Powers, Kyrie Roberts, and Lydia Schleusner. Let's hear it for the JV girls. And girls, you can sit, but some of you will be standing right back up. Our varsity team was composed of Hallie Bauer, Esther Cameron, Brianna Cordell, who was the captain, Kim Goins, Linnea Hayes, Bryn Holman, who was a captain, Olivia Holman, Daria Poor, Kyrie Roberts, and Mally York, who was also a captain. And then we were blessed to have four managers working very hard behind the scenes, Naomi Hoff, Emma Konzenbach, Nora Kratz, and Paige Schoer. Let's hear it for the managers. Next, I have a healthy list of thank yous, and I'm actually going to kind of skim through it. I'm not going to repeat the ones that Mr. Haugley said, but many of the ones that he said are also on my list. And the reason for such a long thank you list is just to have an appreciation for how many people are involved in making an athletic season go as smoothly as they do at GPL. So first, I'd like to thank our coaches, assistant coaches Aaron Schleusner and Cheryl Zeck, both of whom do a wonderful job of helping our young ladies grow as players, as people, and most importantly, as Christ's disciples. And we'll applaud for everybody at the end. Parents, thank you for the many, many, many ways that you support our student athletes. Players, thank you for everything you gave of yourselves for our team and our school and your Savior this season. Managers, thank you for everything that you do so selflessly to help things run smoothly for our team. Cheer team, thank you for your enthusiasm and support of our teams at home games. We're blessed to have two statisticians, Mrs. Swanson and Ms. Deering, who are even willing to travel with us. They do an outstanding job taking stats in max preps, which gives us some really good data to work with and analyze. All the volunteers that Mr. Haugley mentioned. Seth Hansen, Christine Cameron, and others for the awesome pictures that you take. You might see them on Shutterfly if that's been shared with you, but otherwise Seth posts a lot of them on Facebook, and then they get repeated on the GPL Facebook page. And I think every picture in that slideshow was something that they took this season, so thank you for those. Carla, for driving the bus to some of our games, and sometimes she stays back in the dorm so that Ms. Deering and Mr. Wall can travel to games. Student fans, thank you for cheering for us. We're really starting to get the idea of what a student section needs to be, and I think you're starting to make a name for yourselves as one of the best student sections around, so thank you. I'd like to thank my family, my wife Sarah, my daughter Hallie, my son Jarrett, for their patience and support throughout the season. Basketball is on the brain all year, but during the 3 months of the season, it's a tremendous exertion of energy and time, and I thank them for their patience and their support. And then like Mr. Haugley said, most importantly, we thank God for all of these talents that he gives all of these people who use them in ways that bring him glory. So thank you to all of the above. Let's give a round of applause. As I get into talking about our team, the first thing I just want to emphasize is that this is, I have it bold and capitalized on my paper here. This is a great group of girls that makes it very enjoyable and very rewarding to coach them. And I've got about five words that come to mind when I think about them. The first is character. Their Christian character shows itself in so many different ways throughout the season. I can't think of a single moment during the season where I wasn't proud of how they carried themselves and conducted themselves. And beyond the court, they're leaders and role models in the GPL halls every day. Outstanding character in these young ladies. Another one that we used a lot during the season is class. They are a classy bunch. I'm proud of how they represented our Savior in school, everywhere they went, everything that they did. Another word is determined. There were some tough circumstances this season, and I'll talk about those in greater detail, but they didn't always really favor us, but these girls continued to give their best effort through everything that they faced, and they continued to fight every night. And every night isn't, you know, hyperbole. Literally, we were playing sometimes, it felt like every night of the week. These girls are a family. In our postseason meetings, I meet with all of them, and coach meets with some of them too. Nearly every one of them, when asked, what was your favorite part of the season, said, the togetherness that we have on our team. They truly love each other, they genuinely want to help each other, and they are so excited when they see each other succeed. Enthusiastic. It didn't matter where we were playing, we always had the best fans in the bleachers, because if you were at any of our games, you know that we had the JV players sitting behind the varsity bench, and they were the best fans in the stands no matter where we went. So we thank them for them, the JV players, always going nuts for us during our games. And the last word I'm going to use, among many others that could be used, is hungry. These girls badly want to get better, and already just days after the season, they're hitting the gym hard, and I'm really excited about how hard they're going to work in the off season. When I asked our girls again in those postseason meetings, I already mentioned what they most enjoyed. What they least enjoyed about the season, nearly everybody said the same thing, and it had something to do with how COVID affected our season. And they weren't complaining by saying that. They were just acknowledging that it was what it was, and in some ways it did have a negative impact on our season. We went into every game, though, keeping it in perspective. Part of every pregame talk was, we get to play tonight. It's the eighth game of the season, or whatever game it was. What a blessing that we get to play. As Mr. Haugley mentioned, there are some student athletes in our country that didn't get to play a single game this school year. So what a blessing. But I do feel it's appropriate to acknowledge how COVID affected our season. And ultimately, the reason I'm going to go through a few things here about COVID is because it's a testament to how hard our girls worked and how hard they fought through it. So it started with, we got practice underway on schedule, but then before Christmas, we went to distance learning. And that cut practices short, and we tried to keep things going during Christmas break, but it wasn't really everything it could be as far as practice went. We came back from Christmas break, and we had 1 week of school and 1 week of practice, and we played our first game of the season a month after the original first game was scheduled. Our first game was on January 16th. We initially rescheduled all but one of 7 games that we missed either before Christmas or in that week after Christmas, which made for, through January and February, an insanely busy 5-week stretch of games, sometimes numbering 4 or 5 per week. And I would say probably 3 games is the most you should be playing per week to stay healthy and strong. We had 20 practices before we played our first game. After we started playing games, we had 7 practices the rest of the season. So it became nearly all games, very few practices to catch our breath, make adjustments, and continue to learn. So that was something that made it a challenge. When we started playing games, January 16th, like I mentioned, our opponents had already played 5 or 6 games, so they're just starting to hit their stride with conditioning, and they've got some games under their belts, and we're just playing our first games of the season. So for a while there, we were playing catch-up. Catch-up in conditioning, catch-up in game experience, and that was a disadvantage early on, but we worked really hard to catch up. And then there was a stretch in the middle of the season where I think we had caught up. We hadn't worn ourselves out yet, and we had a nice few games where we really started to see some things come together well. And I think that shows us what this team is capable of and hopefully what we can expect from them next year. But then after that sweet spot, then it's playing 4 and 5 games a week, and we worked so hard to catch up, and then very quickly we started to get worn out. And I'm convinced it was that 5-game week where that weekend coaches and players started to test positive for COVID. I'm not a doctor, but what I suspect happened was we were probably exposed to COVID, you know, numerous times throughout the winter and so forth, but we were spending so much time on the bus and in and out of so many gyms, and then finally just wearing our bodies down and weakening our immune systems, and it bit us. But anyway, we went back to distance learning in mid-February. Another stretch of distance learning, and we had to go into our first round of the playoffs having not played a game for 2 weeks and only 2 practices on a Saturday and a Sunday going into Monday's game. And in that game, we came out really We had a really nice halftime lead, and unfortunately, we let it slip away by the end of the game. But I'm convinced that the circumstances did play a role in that. So all in all, we played 14 out of what would have been a full season of 21 to 22 games. And again, we're thankful for each and every one of those opportunities. But I think it's acknowledgement for the girls for how hard they worked to keep fighting through what demonstrates to be pretty difficult COVID-related circumstances. But despite the challenging season, we took some nice steps forward. Compared to last year, we were better as a team in average in nearly every important statistical category, so that was encouraging. I think we grew and continue to grow in our ability to play the style that we want to play and doing that together and understanding how each other plays best. And like Mr. Haugli said, coming back next year is very exciting. So I anticipate that these girls are going to work hard in the offseason. They're going to continue to be extremely committed to improvement, and we're ready for a big step forward next year. Before we get into the awards, I want to give the girls the opportunity to show how this season was bigger than basketball and a tremendous blessing to them. So girls, if you could stand up. I'm just kidding, I'm not gonna make you talk. But I did take from some information that they gave me, and these are quotes, I'm not gonna tell you who said what, but this is what the season meant to these girls. One girl said, "My trust with the girls on this team has grown so much this year. We grew like a family, and it was always a good time going on the court with all of them." Another said, "This season brought me so much closer to everyone around me, coaches, players, and managers. I love the feeling of unity and togetherness our team held throughout the season. No matter what happened this season, I always knew my team would stay together." Another said, "This season helped me understand the importance of teamwork. I want it more next year." Another said, "The way our team acted inspired me so much. Like our coaches always say, we're a classy bunch, and I totally agree. This team has just made me a better teammate and person in general." And one more player said, "This season I was encouraged by my sisters in Christ because of their kind words and encouraging my faith and basketball. They made me realize how much bigger it is than basketball than I ever had." So thank you, girls, for those sentiments. Now we'll get into recognizing some accomplishments and some awards. First, the varsity letters. Student-athletes who earned a varsity letter this season, and you can stand and then we'll clap for you, include Hallie Bauer, Brianna Cordell, Kim Goins, Linnea Hayes, Bryn Holman, Olivia Holman, Daria Poor, Kyrie Roberts, and Mally York. Let's clap for them. Thank you, girls. We also award managers or letters to managers that earn them, and all of four of our managers more than earned a letter this season. So please stand, Naomi Hoff, Emma Konzenbach, Nora Kratz, and Paige Shore. Nice job, ladies. I do want to acknowledge a few career and season statistics accomplishments. Making her way up the career rebounds list, Bryn Holman to fifth place with 376 career rebounds. Career blocks, Mally York cracked the top 10 at 10th with 19. Mally can laugh about this. This is kind of a funny stat. On the season blocks records, a particular player or two have their name mentioned several times in the top 10. One of them, I think, is Jordan Zeck, who probably has like four seasons that are in the season top 10. But she only goes into the career blocks top 10 one time. So it creates a situation where Mally at 19 blocks actually had fewer blocks than some of those single season best. And Mally can laugh about that. But Mally did do a very nice job swatting some shots this year. Career three-point field goals, Mally cracked the top 10 at 24. Season free throw percentage, Bryn cracked the top 10 at 64%. And I'm going to acknowledge this one, even though it's not an official record, but she was one attempt away from earning a single season top mark. Kim Goins shot 42% from three-pointers, and she needed 20 attempts to be acknowledged for the season, and she only had 19 because of our shortened season. But I'm confident she may have put her name high on that list. Unfortunately, our shortened season kept her away. But next year, we'll get that taken care of. And then we do have some special awards. So Mr. Haugli mentioned that each team acknowledges a couple of different awards, and then we'll get to our most valuable player and our Panther Award as well. So this first one is most improved, and it's going to go to Olivia Holman. I'll give it to you at the end. So as we got into the season, it very quickly became apparent that Olivia deserved a starting position on our varsity team as a freshman, and she earned every minute of it throughout the season. Throughout the season, she grew in her strength and her ability to use her height to her advantage. She has started to develop a nice arsenal of go-to moves in the post, and I anticipate she'll continue to add to that. She's extremely coachable, and she uses everything that she earns, or learns, I'm sorry, but she earned the most improved award. Come on up, Olivia. Next, we have a special award that's unique to GPL girls basketball. We started awarding it last year. It's the 2x4 award. Last year, I told the story of where the 2x4 comes from. This year, I'll say if you really want to know, you can ask one of the players. But ultimately, the 2x4 award goes to the player who hit the hardest all season. And when we say hit the hardest, part of every pregame talk is swing the 2x4 tonight, girls. I'll show it to you. So we start the season with an empty 2x4. And then every game throughout the season, we coaches pick a recipient of the 2x4 for that game. And this thing goes wherever we go. So sometimes when we take it into visiting gyms, they kind of wonder, why is this guy carrying around a piece of wood? But that's the reason behind the 2x4. So throughout the season, many different people earned the award in some more than one game. And Bryn in particular, I think the most of any player, 4 games, I believe. And ultimately, that's what led her teammates and coaches to vote Bryn Holman as the recipient of the Season 2x4 Award. Come on up, Bryn. So that's Bryn's second 2x4 Award. She's starting to start a collection in her room. Most Valuable Player. The player who was our all-around best player and had the greatest impact on our team's success. So the description, and then I'll tell you who it goes to. Our coaches and players recognize this player as our most valuable player, clearly without a doubt, in the voting and so forth. She averaged 8 points and 8 rebounds per game. I think next year she's going to become an average double-double. She's right on the verge of that. And she played outstanding defense throughout the season. It was hard to take her out of the game, first of all, because she didn't want to come out of the game, but we really needed her on the court. Like Coach Haugley said, during a season where we lacked experience, Bryn really needed to stay out there. Outstanding defense, often asked to guard the opposition's most talented. Did I say her name already? I'm sorry. Opposition's best post player. And when we were having our all-conference meeting with the other coaches, I suspect that other teams' players hate the night when Bryn's going to be guarding them because she makes their lives very difficult. So I've already said it a few times now. Bryn, congratulations on being our most valuable player. I won't try to keep the Panther Award a secret. We'll just tell you who it is right off the bat, and then I'll explain why. We could not pick one person for the Panther Award this year. There's two people that are very deserving, and so we're going to give it to two. And they are Brianna Cordell and Mally York. It's interesting that they're both very deserving of this award, but they earned it in different. Brie is a force of positivity on our team and a tremendous cheerleader of her teammates. Mally, while bearing the weight of being our team's point guard and seldom coming out of the game, encouraged and led her teammates on the court every step of the way. So congratulations to Brie and Mally on the Panther Award. And with that, I'll just conclude by thanking you again for the privilege of celebrating the 2020-21 Panther Girls basketball season with you this evening. To God be the glory.
All the girls that got either a plaque or a trophy, we'll have you guys congregate out in the commons. Mrs. Swanson is going to take a picture. And then at the end of the evening, we want all of the plaque and trophy winners to take one picture. We'll probably do that on the bleachers. So those girls that did get something there, you can head over there. All right. Our next group is the one-act performance, and yes, Mr. Martins is ready. Come on over, Mr. Martins.
Good afternoon, everyone. Try to keep this as short as our season was. Anyway, I rehearsed that one. Yeah, I did. I don't know. I can't remember what year it was. I remember, you know, feeling kind of stressed out or bad for myself. One year we lost a few rehearsals because some students had the flu, and so we closed the dorm down for a day or two or something, and it's like, oh, just, I don't think we can put together a one-act season in that short amount of time again. Well, nonetheless, we got the opportunity. Our one-act play season generally, if I can, we'll audition right the week of the concert, and then we'll probably start rehearsals right the week after the concert. Well, if you were at the last concert, you kind of know how that went, and then didn't quite get back to school on time, so that left us January 11th or something, somewhere in there. I can't remember the exact date. And then we returned. We had a week of school, and then we had our region competition on the Wednesday following. So we ended up with about 9 rehearsals on our one-act play season, and it went by fast, and I was not sure how that was all going to come together, but by God's grace and the dedication of some outstanding individuals, I'm very proud of the show that we were able to put together. Our production this year was Teachers on the Verge of a Nervous Breakdown. I don't know, theme of my life, something. Anyway, it was a fun show, and we had a lot of quality performances. And one of the judges emailed me after. Maybe I should talk a little bit about the season, then I'll get to that. So our one-act play season, I need to give a shout-out. Our region competition was supposed to be here in town at Watertown High School, and they weren't allowing performances in their theater, so we went down to SDSU in Brookings. So we got to perform in front of one individual in our audience, so yay, Carla, thanks for being our one audience member. She got in because she drove the bus, so I'm sure there would have been many more, but the judges were there, so I guess they count as audience, but they were being all judgy. Anyway, that was really an interesting opportunity to have a 800-seat auditorium and to perform. There's a couple of judges out there somewhere, and oh, there's Carla. It was a great performance. I was very thankful for the opportunity that we did get to do it on a stage. Perhaps some of you saw our recorded version that we did here in the gym, I believe, right? Yeah, I have the recording, but I haven't watched it for some time now. Yeah, we recorded that in the gym, but the opportunity to be on stage, there's just something about bringing the characters to life and creating the atmosphere that you can do in theater, and I'm very excited for the opportunity that we get to do that in our own space, Lord willing, next year for the one-act play season. There was no designated category, and originally I was leaning towards drama. They did that to give us some flexibility as directors, and I was leaning towards a drama, but I didn't really know if we needed any more drama in our lives, so we ended up with Teachers on the Verge of a Nervous Breakdown. At the region competition, the judges, we first performance of the judges were very complimentary. And one of the judges emailed me afterwards, just a couple of things. I'm flabbergasted, to say the least, for what your cast was able to put together in the amount of time that you had. They should be very proud of the high-quality educational theater that they bring for us and for others to enjoy. And that does summarize many of my feelings. I'm flabbergasted at what we were able to do in such a short amount of time, but believing in the gifts that God has given them and believing in each other, that's you know, what it's going to take to get that performance together. So it was unfortunately, we did not advance to the state competition, but I think a testament to how strong the performance was is that we ended up with 8 outstanding performers on the day, which is as many as the other shows, the two shows that went on to the state competition. So I think that speaks to how strong our performance was and really how close we were to continuing on. I'm going to read for you our letter winners, and participants can get their certificates in Mrs. Guthmiller's room. I hope that was okay. I didn't ask. Okay. I put them in Mrs. Guthmiller's room on the participation. The participants can stand, and then we will acknowledge our group of participants, and then we'll acknowledge our letter winners. Receiving a participation certificate, Alexis Goshi, Hannah Berg, you can stand as I say your name, Aiden Crowley, Gianna Proya, Austin Adams, Nolan Hansen, Jenna Lindemann, and Lizzie Konzenbach. Thank you. You can have a seat. One other thing I could explain is that the theater of lettering, there's an accumulation that occurs. So based on the type of role and all of that. So the next group of individuals that are receiving a letter is because of their role in the one-act play and then a previous role that they had completed. So points that they had previously earned and now points that they additionally earned from one-act play. So these are some theater letter winners. They can stand and be recognized. Naomi Hoff, Lucas Yeager, and Haley Coles. Congratulations. And then the following individuals were the individuals that received superior medals for their performance in the one-act play and are also receiving a varsity letter for one-act play. You can stand when I read your name. Lydia Kratz, Bailey Wolf, Darian Rosenthal, Nora Kratz, Jackson Coles, Sebastian Rosenthal, John Abrahamson, and David Sell. Great work, everybody, great work. You can have a seat. Thank you again, everyone, for your work. This, 8 superior medals on a year that we did not advance to the state competition. I think that's really, really quite outstanding that has not ever happened for us before. We have 2 special awards to give. The first is MVP. And our MVP, it was really challenging. I wasn't exactly sure how this was going to work, and I was trying to think through many different qualifiers in a short season. And the students voted, and as I was reflecting, there was kind of a common theme and some comments that were made. I just, our MVP winner really continued to reflect on individual opportunities to not just strengthen themselves, but strengthen the show, and I thought brought a really strong performance, and this individual can come up to receive their award. Congratulations, Nora Kratz. Congratulations. Our final award is the Panther Award, and the Panther Award goes to an individual who continued to encourage me and the cast and probably was hardest on themselves, maybe because they have a tendency to overthink some things, so that might give some things away, but anyway, a great encourager, and I'm very proud to award the Panther Award to Bailey Wolf. Congratulations to all to the entire cast and crew. Again, I am very thankful. I'm looking forward to a full season next year. Hopefully, you know, get started and actually have some opportunity to get some other things together in a new space. Really exciting times ahead for One Act Play. So, I should say thank you to. Many people probably, but a couple of names that come to my mind. One individual I would like to say thank you to Dee Dee Rosenthal for also continuing to be there and encourage and randomly popping in and asking me questions. How are things going? What do you need? That sort of thing. That's really encouraging. And when everything's happening in such a short amount of time, appreciate it. I know you're in here somewhere. Oh, there you are. Hi. So thank you very much. And of course, my wife, she gets to do the exact same thing that I get to do in Henry. And so sometimes I ask her questions about certain things and she's like, I don't know. I don't want to tell you what we're doing. She's just kidding. She's very encouraging and having that support and people to bounce ideas off of. I'm very thankful for. So thank you, and thank you to everyone for your support for the One Act Play cast and crew.
So again, those that did receive an award there for One Act can head out, and Mrs. Swanson will take their picture. Without a doubt, the coach that's gonna stand before you tonight that had the most adjustments this winter is coming up right now. And I can't even tell the whole story as good as she probably can. So Coach Johnson, let's go talk about cheerleading.
All these tall guys before me. Good afternoon. I'm Coach Jenna Johnson. I'd like to start by thanking Mr. Bauer and Mr. Haugley for their support and being my connection to the student body and helping with communication this year. Like he said, there were a lot of twists and turns with everything that happened, and I probably would not have held it together as well as I did without them, so thank you. I obviously echo all the other thanks the other coaches have also expressed, so thank you. Next, I have a little synopsis of the year in the form of a poem. Unique is one way to describe this season. COVID was one of the many reasons. Entire weeks canceled, rescheduled games, but there was no one we could blame. Even so, I was beyond impressed. Each of the girls tried their best. They learned the skills and cheered so loudly. We practiced a dance and a lift so proudly. With a small squad this year, I was able to see each member's strengths individually. Leadership, rhythm, drive, and heart, each cheerleader did her part to make this truly a successful year. It makes me so happy, I want to cheer. We had a small squad this year of only three girls, two of which had never cheered before. Normally, I would see that as a setback. We had to teach the cheers, the school songs, the moves, and formations all from scratch. However, we know that in all things, God works for our good, and it also allowed some new leadership to emerge and talent to shine, turning it into a great opportunity. My only disappointment this year was we didn't get the opportunity to perform our dance routine, which included a true cheer stunt, something that would have been a first for me as coach. All three athletes have earned letters by participating in 90% of this season's events, and those are Ruby Lyons, Chloe Wolf, and Daisy Holloway. I have three awards to present, and I would like to start with Ruby Lyons. Ruby noticeably put in extra time on her own to be ready for practices and games. She showed consistent improvement between cheer events. And for all her hard work, I am awarding Ruby this year's Most Improved Award. My next award is going to Daisy Holloway. Daisy was one of my, or was my only veteran cheerleader, which made her the leader by default. But Daisy really shined in this role. She called the cheers, she set the pace, and she was in front of most of the formations. It seemed like it came naturally to her, and I was proud of how she handled it all. Daisy is this year's MVP. And finally, by process of elimination, you can guess that this year's Panther Award is going to Chloe Wolf. At the start of the season, it seemed that cheer was a little outside of Chloe's comfort zone. However, she quickly impressed me with how quickly she picked up the cheers and moves. Toward the end of the season, she even became the flyer of our half elevator lift. This shows her willingness to try new things, and she excelled at each one. Congratulations, Chloe. Thank you again for making this a special season, and I'm already looking forward to building on what we accomplished next year. Thank you.
Rumor has it I can be a little long-winded, so why don't we take a one-minute stretch break? I know the middle seats aren't comfortable. Get up, stretch, move around. 1 minute, ready, go. All right. Our last group, boys basketball, and someone told me I have to do it, although I tried to convince Coach Swanson to do it, but he wasn't taking it, so. What a crazy year for the boys basketball team. What a fun team to coach. What displays of athleticism and skill and just a whole bunch of stuff that I get to talk about here this year. It's a tremendous honor and privilege to get to have this responsibility at the school, and I take it very seriously, and I'm very thankful for everyone associated with our program, parents, student athletes, coaches, supporters, everybody. I'd like to also start by thanking my wife, Susie. If I weren't able to be here, you allow me to do my job here at the school. Whether it's coaching boys basketball, teaching, athletic directoring, yes, that's a word, your ability to just be so strong without me always having to be home, and it's every winter, it's a different gym every night, but literally that was the way it was this year, even more so. So I'm so thankful for you that you allow me to be able to do what I get to do here at the school in this ministry, so thank you, Susie. I'd like to thank Carla for driving us all over the state again this year. I'd also like to thank all of my coaches. I want to make sure I got the entire list. Maybe the boys don't even remember. Coach Wall, Coach Swanson, and Coach Dearson. Maybe he's tuning in live. We'll see. Thank you to all the coaches, all the work, all the dedication, all the hours that we spent after practice talking about the practice or the scheme for the next game or whatever. Fun to be able to talk shop with my coaching staff. It's so wonderful as a head coach to know that your assistant coaches are buying into the scheme that you're trying to install as a leader of the program. When I'm working on one side of the court with the varsity boys, I can literally just open my ears a little bit towards the other side and hear Coach Wall yelling basketball stuff at the JV boys, and I know that he's installing good habits and good practices with the young guys as well. So thank you to all of my assistant coaches throughout the year. I'd also like to thank our live streaming crew, those that made it possible to get our games out to all the people. I'd like to thank our cheerleaders that were able to bring an added dimension to the student section, and of course the students. I've had multiple coaches come up to me and say how much they hate to play in this place because of how much our students get behind us. And it's fun. And it was a lot of fun again this year, so thank you for the energy. I'd like to start by introducing our team members, so we'll start with the JV team. For the first time ever, we included eighth graders in the boys' basketball program. We had 19 high schoolers play basketball this winter, and we wanted a few more. And so four eighth graders from St. Martin's joined and played both JV and St. Martin's eighth grades. They're very busy boys, literally leaving a practice after school and running over here for the last hour of our practice some nights. They definitely got an experience that not many others have had. So our eighth graders, Hayden Carley, stand up, Landon Zerwan, Seth Grams, and Micah Holine. You guys can stay standing real quick. The remainder of our JV team, the freshmen, Aiden Johnson, Kevin Tate, Jacob Bartels, Thomas Erickson, Miles York, Alex Heil, sophomores Parker Watkins, Levi Holloway, and junior Elijah Grams, our JV team. Thanks, guys. You can sit down. I'll talk about the JV season in a moment. There were different types of awards that were voted for, and there are some that are a little bit less serious, a little more go with the flow funny, that our varsity guys were awarded. So I'm going to get those out of the way as I introduce the varsity players to you. We're going to go top down for the varsity. So seniors, quite a group of seniors. Captain Andrew Heil, stand up. Andrew, you got a couple of goofy awards. You got Mr. Handles for the best dribbler and Mr. Vice Grip for the best triple threat player. Colin Yeager, Pierce Olin, Captain Logan Lausing, who got a few awards. Mr. Floorburn, there's a theme here. Mr. Floorburn, Mr. Black and Blue, and Mr. Future Coach. Logan, thank you. And Nolan Hansen, who received Mr. Encourager. And if you ever watched a single one of our games, you know why. Our juniors on varsity, Connor Canas, Sam Hansen. Sam won a couple goofy awards. Mr. Clean, like clean on the windows, for the best rebounder. Mr. Spin Cycle for best post moves. Ethan Jensted, who won Mr. Sniper for our best shooter. And Mr. Nat, like G-N-A-T, the most annoying on-ball defender. Trent Lean, who won Mr. Box Out. And Gavin Dornbush. Rounding out our varsity team, two freshmen, Alex Heil and Miles York. And our three managers, Olivia Zanto, Kylie Lausing, and Martin Rosh. Our varsity team. Thanks, guys. You can have a seat. Reflecting on the entire season real briefly, obviously, you have to start with COVID. As Principal Bauer highlighted, a shutdown in December, 1 week into the season, and then a shutdown in February as we were rolling. Not the ideal situation. The JV team played 13 games total. The varsity got 14 regular season games in. I'm extremely thankful for the situation that we had this year with the personnel on our team. There were so many veterans that knew what it takes to be competitive at this level that even though maybe we weren't physically in person, especially during the December break, I knew they were working. Whether that was back home or whether that was them all driving up to Aberdeen or whatever it took to get into a gym and practice and work together, the fact that we were able to get into the swing of things so quickly in January, once we were able to play games, is a testament to the experience and the dedication of our experienced players. So many boys were coming back for their third year of varsity basketball, and that completely changed the trajectory of the year. We had one bad game when we got into the beginning, and it went up in Aberdeen. Unfortunately, it was in front of our folks up there at Trinity. But it took us one game to get back into the competitive swing of things, and then we were right back at it playing competitive basketball from there on out. Same thing when we came back in February. It took us that 1 week, couple opponents, and then we were ready to play quality playoff basketball. So I'm very thankful to our leaders on the team, both juniors and seniors, that took the horns and led the team and said, this is what we need to do in order to be in shape. The only thing that really stood out to me as I reflected on the year was the limited number of practices. As you can imagine, game, no practices. Normally in a season, we get about 40 official practices. We got 19 this year, officially. So obviously that had a big impact on our cohesion and especially the development of our players. When I reflect on the JV season, again, the eighth graders are the first thing that comes to mind. It's kind of a unique opportunity for them, and I hope the experience that they gained and the playing time that they earned on the JV team will help them in the future. Very much look forward to them being freshmen in our program next year. Of any group of players, though, that was impacted by the lack of practice, it was the young guys. Being on JV is hard. When you come in and we have players from all different settings, all different types of backgrounds, and they need to learn how to gel with each other. They need to learn what their teammates' skills and abilities are. And unfortunately, they didn't get that practice time. But I still saw the growth. I still saw that teamwork and that cohesion happen in the games. And it's hard to always judge that by JV, because one night you're playing against a bunch of 8th and 9th graders, and the next night you're playing against 11th graders that are the first guy off the varsity bench. And different programs run their JVs differently, and sometimes that leads to the scores being competitive one night, not so competitive the next night. We play 8th graders, we play 9th graders, and we play others as well, but we're playing the young guys, and we're developing them, okay? It was so fun to see them gel, and I'm thinking of the JV season, and it was such a wonderful opportunity to see them come together right before we got shut down. We were in Arlington, and they played the most complete game I've seen a JV team play here in several years. Inside, outside, defense, it was just incredible. And then everything got stopped, and they lost that momentum. So for all the JV players, I've said this in the locker room to you guys in the season. I said, I don't always tell JV teams this, but the JV group has a ton of potential, and I'm extremely excited for this group of young players to keep growing together as teammates and to keep working on their skills to replace so many of the important players that are at the varsity level in a very short amount of time. And so I'm very much looking forward to this JV team growing up in our program for the future. I would also be remiss if I did not mention Coach Wall, specifically in the JV. Coach Wall, thank you for your 2 years of coaching this team. Your time at GPO will be coming to an end at the end of this year. We look forward to seeing where you get reassigned. And I've joked with you many times, have fun with the fifth grade girls wherever you're at next year, coaching them some basketball. Thank you, Coach Wall. When I reflect on the varsity season, our theme for the year was raise the bar. You see that on the posters if you pick one up on the way out. Part of that is just looking sheerly at the record, and we won more games this year than last year, and we won more than the year before, and we didn't even play as many games, obviously. So I'm extremely impressed with the effort, and I'm very happy for the boys with the results that we got, and quite frankly, with some different things happening in a couple of games, some circumstances going differently, that record certainly would look even better. Certainly the highlight towards the end of the year was earning our first playoff victory. We'd been talking about it as a program that it had been quite a while since we had notched a playoff victory. And we probably made it a little bit more exciting than it needed to be up in Webster, but players make plays, and Andrew, is the best deal of your career. Okay, so glad that we were able to get that playoff victory against Britton-Hecla. So I was very grateful that we were able to get a couple games under our belt coming back from our February break so that we could perform, and we sure gave the number one seed a pretty good scare the next night, too. The varsity team, these guys are so smart when it comes to basketball. We talk about basketball IQ sometimes as coaches, and players just know what to do with the ball, without the ball, how to play defense, and that was something that was the most enjoyable as a coach, was to see that basketball IQ on display. The other thing that really stood out with this group of varsity players for me was how close-knit they were. I think this is a trait that you will never show up on stats, but it's such an important thing for a basketball team. You need to be able to be extremely tight-knit. They would always go hang out with each other. I know a certain weekends they'd all hang out at someone's house and just have an enjoyable time being brothers together. You need that because you need to be able to go through the ups and downs of the season, the ups and downs of a game together, and that cohesion goes a long way. The other thing that sticks out for me personally is the seniors. I've been coaching basketball in the high school ranks for almost 10 years now, and this is my first group, believe it or not, that I've had all 4 years through high school. The seniors were freshmen when I took over the boys program many years ago here. And these five seniors that we have, they're good basketball players, but the thing I'm most proud of, and parents, I hope you agree with me, all five of these guys are tremendous young men, and they're going to do tremendous things after they graduate from this place in a couple of months. But they're pretty good basketball players, too. We also had to deal with the injury bug. Logan had to deal with an ankle chronic injury throughout the majority of the season. Whenever we did practice, we rarely had Logan, which presented some challenges. And then Trent with the knee injury in the Wilmot game, he lost the last month of his season. I'm happy to report that we've had a successful surgery and looking forward to Trent being completely healthy for his senior year, and I can't wait for that for you too. Let's go on now to identify those who earned a varsity letter this year. When I read your name, you can stand up. Receiving their first varsity letters, Nolan Hansen and Pierce Soline. Receiving a second varsity letter. Yep, go ahead and stand up. We'll clap for all of you at the end. Second varsity letter, Colin Yeager. Third varsity letters, Logan Lausing and Andrew Heil. For the juniors, receiving their first varsity letters, Trent Lean, Gavin Dornbush, and Connor Canas. Receiving his third varsity letter, Ethan Genstead and Sam. Our varsity letter winners for the year. Everybody can sit down except for Nolan and Pierce. I'm going to pick on my seniors real briefly if I could. I'm going to talk about both of you together because there's a lot of similarities between the two of you. Both of you have been part of our program throughout your high school career, and you've worked extremely hard to make this team better. The time when you shined was in practice. And I was you when I was a high schooler, and so I can relate to the role that you played for our team. You had the toughest job on the team. Bench mob is fun, but they did not always perform on the court every single night for our team. The positive attitude that both of you displayed towards the team was tremendous, and you were the leaders of the bench mob, and bench mob is a fun thing to do. Nolan, in particular, probably set a state record for jumping higher than anyone else off the bench whenever something good was happening. Whenever I'd watch film, there'd be this head bopping up and down after the shot was going down or something like that. So thank you for your enthusiasm, Nolan. Pierce's energy on our guards, like Andrew and Ethan and Colin, made them more prepared to see tough defenses in games. Every practice I talked to the defense that we need to see game-like varsity defense, not half defense. And Pierce brought it every day. So thanks to both of you for your energy and your commitment to our program. Nolan, Pierce, thank you. Colin. Colin overcame an ACL injury his sophomore year, which cost him most of his junior season. But he grew to be a very reliable player off the bench. Colin demonstrated his smarts by being in the right place on defense, by running all the plays right, in spite of him playing multiple positions, depending on who else was on the court with him. Colin's aggression, specifically in our playoff win against Britton Hecla, was a huge contributing factor to our victory. Thanks for the 4 years, well, 3.5-ish years when you were healthy, Colin. Andrew. Andrew has been our team leader for 3 years now. A smooth lefty shooter is what many will think of when recalling your game, but I'll never forget the night this winter when I asked you who's going to guard the opponent's best player each night. You wanted it. It didn't matter if it was a guard or a forward, you wanted him. Your ability to drive and either score or get rid of the ball to open teammates was absolutely tremendous. Your playmaking ability was unlike anything I've seen in a long time. A captain must love his team, all of its members. You did that. Nobody was happier for a teammate's success than you. Watch the film, it shows. Whether that teammate was a fellow senior that you've been playing with forever, or a freshman that was in their first varsity game in their entire career, you were extremely excited for their success. Thank you for your leadership in this program for the last 4 years, and I'm so glad you grew from that 5'4", 100-pound frame that you came in as a freshman. Thanks, Andrew. Finally, Logan. Logan toughed out a very painful injury this year to give our team everything that he had. Logan was always capable of hitting a three, but he really found success this season attacking the rim for layups and also drawing charges on defense. I think you were top 10 in the state for a while, right? Yeah. Logan loves basketball, and he's worked so hard during his 4 years to be the player that he has become. It hurt my heart to see him deal with this injury this year, and we missed him in the games that he wasn't able to play. Logan, your toughness, your basketball IQ, and the love for this game meant so much to me and for our team. Thank you for the last 4 years, Logan. As I said, this was a really fun team to watch, and we did some really fun things, and the statistics kind of reared out. Please allow me a moment to brag about some of the things that our juniors and seniors on varsity were able to do. Sam, you're first. 117 rebounds is the 10th best season ever. 19 blocks is the third best season ever. 30 three-point makes puts you 10th in the best season ever. This was a close one throughout the whole year. Pay attention to this number. We're going to come back to it in just a second. 41.1% from three-point range was the fourth best season ever. And your 79.2% from the free throw line, percentage-wise, was the best ever. Congratulations, Sam. I know he's not here today, but we're going to brag about Ethan Jenstead next. Ethan made 31 threes this year for the eighth best season ever, and he shot a three-point percentage just a little higher than Sam at 41.3, which put him third best season. Congratulations, Ethan. Now to the seniors. Andrew. I'm going to save the best one for last. There's a lot of them. 9 blocks this year. Good thing you grew. 8th best all time for a season. 14 career blocks does put you 10th, but that's going to go away next year when Sam graduates, so enjoy it while it lasts. 3-point makes, 86 in your career, that puts you 4th all-time. And your 3-point percentage was 29.7, that's 6th best for a career. But here's where it's cool. In spite of missing so many games this year, you still had 101 assists. That is easily the best. Easily. And that puts you at 180 assists for the entire career. That's the 3rd best all-time. Congratulations, Andrew. And Logan, our final one here, 46 career three-pointers made puts you 7th all-time, and your 30.5 three-point percentage for the career puts you 5th all-time. Congratulations, Logan. For the first time in 3 years, we were able to place 2 individuals on the all-conference team selected by the conference coaches. This year, in second team for all-conference, was Andrew Heil, and on the first team for all conference was Sam Hansen. And now to the trophies. Our first award is the Newcomer of the Year. This freshman group is filled with guys who have tons of potential, but one rose above the rest. He was a leader on the JV team, often leading the JV team in scoring. I'm very optimistic of this young man's future. Our newcomer of the year is Alex Heil. Most improved. Our program is all about improvement. It's safe to say that many players have a legitimate claim to this award. This player saw his role increase perhaps more than any other from last year, and I hope his upward trajectory continues for next season. This year's most improved player is Trent Lean. Defensive Player of the Year. Our team goal this year was to play better defense than last year, and statistics would show that we did. And many guys performed well to make that happen. The winner for Defensive Player of the Year led, or nearly led, our team in steals, rebounds, blocks, and deflections. Our Defensive Player of the Year is Sam Hansen. MVP. Value is sometimes difficult to define. Sometimes the stats are crystal clear, but other times stats can only help because there's intangibles that matter just as much. Our team voting saw only two different players receive votes for this award, but there's no doubt that they both deserve strong consideration. Leaders in nearly every category, these two displayed their value on both offense and defense. I could not justify awarding this to just one player and not the other. So, our co-MVPs this year are Sam Hansen and Andrew Heil. And finally, our Panther Award. This goes to a player who absolutely loves this team. Often, not only this year, but in past years as well, this player has taken younger teammates under his wing. They would teach the nuances of the game to these young players, and his love for Panther basketball was contagious. I'm very proud of the young man he became. These statements probably don't narrow it down very much, because we had a lot of people who were worthy of consideration. But this year, I'm very proud to say that our winner for the Panther Award is Logan Lausing. As I look forward to the offseason and getting ready for next year, the obvious things are we have five juniors looking to become seniors from this year's team, and I'm going to be leaning on them for their leadership. But then, which young players are going to take the next step and become very important players on varsity? Work hard this offseason. Become the best athletes that you can be, become the best ball players that you can be, so that we can continue to raise the bar in the years ahead. November 29th, 2021. Who's counting? I am. Thank you. As I switch hats one more time, I have a couple more thank yous before I send you on your way. First of all, I would like to thank the Booster Club, a group that maybe doesn't always get the recognition that they deserve. Just a tremendous blessing from our school. They're often the ones that coordinate the concession stands at all of our games, both here and at the football stadium, and just a group that very much cares about all Panther athletics, not just the winter activities. From the athletic director side of things, again, I'm just so overwhelmed by the amount of people that volunteer to make things happen here. Very recently, the conference schools put together a spreadsheet of how much they pay different jobs throughout the athletic realm. And it's just incredible the amount of things that we have people that just volunteer their time and do that never happen at other schools because no one is just willing to do it. It needs to be a paid position or something like that. And I'm just so very grateful that you're able to keep our expenses down by volunteering your time and doing a very good job while doing it. So thank you to every volunteer, especially this year in the era of COVID. There were just so many extra things extra rules, extra considerations, and things like that to be taken. And none of that happens without our tremendous amount of volunteers. And so I'm extremely grateful to them. And then once more, I just want to echo the same sentiments from the very beginning, but they're worth mentioning again. I'd like to thank those in charge of the live streaming, our students that worked, Mr. Kleinke and Mr. Rosenthal, that coordinated and made sure our technology was working. All of the coaches had an assistant that spent so much time dedicating to our student athletes, and then also to the student athletes for using your gifts to the best of your ability. And I know it's March Madness and Selection Sunday is happening right now, and some of you have hungry tummies and sore butts. And so I'd like to just say thank you once more. And finally, if you're heading home, especially if you're heading home where there's some potential weather, please drive home safely. And I'm just so grateful for the opportunity that we've had to do this in person and reflect on the tremendous blessings that we had here in the winter season. Thank you. I should remind while we still have people here, if you earned a trophy, let's gather. Mrs. Swanson, maybe we do it right where the projector is. We'll just move the table and we'll take that picture quick, and then we'll all be on our way.